Hello everyone, back tuning in to today's first video. We're going to have a look at where next week, the same day, so today's first video is to take us to around the 31st of January. Day 10 will be the final day of the month. So we're able to extend a little bit beyond that, actually, with the extended GFS and ECMWF. They went around a couple of weeks, the ECM ensembles and the extended GFS. And we'll also have a look at the CFS V2 for the next month as well. Tonight we've got Snowwatch coming up, so we're not going to get those bitterly cold easterly winds unleashed at the end of the week, but it looked like we would get 2 or 3 days ago. They've been cancelled, and we talked about that in the video yesterday, so I don't think we need to go over that again. It's going to still be quite cold. We're still going to have winds from a north to northwesterly direction. It will be cold enough at times to produce snow. One of those situations will be tomorrow. Not so much tonight, where we've got this active front coming down. That's primarily going to be rain. Could be little bits of snow on the back edge and over high ground, but I don't think it'll amount to too much. The main problem tonight will be ice, real ice risk in the north. But tomorrow we've got wintry showers, and some of those showers will be pretty potent and they will produce snow for some of us. So more about that in Snow Watch coming up this evening. But the week 10 day video update starts us off, and we're going to begin by having a look at the central England temperature. So this is the very latest with the CET from Hadley. We're currently standing at 5.1 provisional to yesterday, 20th of January. That's an anomaly of 1.6 degrees above average, so still quite significantly milder than average, but it's going to come down more than that, I think, and I expect it's going to finish up somewhere like in the sort of low fours to high threes, that sort of area. So let's say perhaps around 3.8 to maybe 4.3, something like that would be, I suspect, the finishing number. I think there's going to be quite a big downwards correction as well this month. That's what I've heard on the forum. So I think we'll finish up low fours to high threes. Probably not too far from average in the end. And that would be quite a cool down after what was a very mild start to the month indeed. 500 millibar height anomaly flowcharts from Penn State University for next week, 10 days, looking like this. We've got the ECMWF on the top, and the GFS, which you'll have a look at in a moment, is on the bottom. 500 millibars, 8,000 meters area in the actual high pressure, low pressure, are being moved around by the jet stream running above. Retroplates high pressure, blue to low pressure. ECM is placing a big trough of below average heights over and pretty much covering the whole of Western Europe, actually, in the week to 10 day time frame. We have a ridge out in the middle of the Atlantic, but not getting up to green and not northern blocking. We've got the flow of the jet going something a little bit like that, so we're pulling in quite cold air into this trough of below average heights. The air is being pulled out of the North Atlantic and Greenland into that trough. It's not true Arctic or Siberian air. You'll see that over the pole itself there's no real northern blocking signal. So to get true Arctic air, we need to take this ridge that's in the middle of the Atlantic and push it northwards, centre it around there somewhere. And if we was to do that, then we would pump out or push out the very cold true Arctic air into that trough of below average heights. Nevertheless, this is still a cold scenario. We are still bringing the air out of the North Atlantic and out of Greenland into that trough of below average heights. And we're on the cold side of the jet stream, and it is probably cold enough at times for snow. The GFS is looking like this, and it's a very similar situation. So again, we've got this area of below average heights over the UK and much of Western Europe as well. The above average heights are out in the middle of the Atlantic, not getting themselves up to Greenland at this stage. There is some high pressure to the north of Scandinavia, somewhere around Svalbard. But overall, it's the same sort of situation, very deep trough as well into the east of America. So winter, excuse me, will be really biting through there. So it's the same sort of thing as what the ECM is showing, really. We've got the jet stream doing something rather like that on the cold side of the jet. We're underneath a trough of low pressure in the 500 millibar flow. And so it looks pretty cold and pretty unsettled. You will be pulling the air out of Greenland and the North Atlantic into that trough of below average heights. But again, it's not real Arctic sourced air coming from the North Pole or coming from Siberia. So cold, yes. Unsettled, yes. Big freeze remains on hold at the moment. GFS temperature and precipitation ensembles are looking like this. Look at Bradford today. Someone's asked to have a look at Bradford. They have started updating the ensembles at West Central, so we are now able to continue with the list of suggested places. And next up on our list is Bradford today. So the red line here is the 30-year upper air temperature average for Bradford. You can see that at the moment we're colder than average. You've got this pickup in the temperature coming up at the end of the week. So it's going to go a little bit milder around Friday, possibly lasting into Saturday, but it's very temporary. And after that, we're back into pretty cold conditions once again. Again, we are talking about cold rather than very cold. So we're somewhere between around -5, -10 in terms of the upper air temperatures. We have got that outlier member there, that gold run that eventually gets down to -15. So that's going into the freeze or anything between around -10, -15 at 850 HPA. Around here, that's going to take you into the freezer, but that's a one-off. Most of these ensemble members are between around -5 and -10, so it continues to be a case that it's cold, yes, but big freeze not particularly. As far as precipitation is concerned, that's how it's looking. And regular precipitation spikes coming through, so that's a wet weather pushing through tonight and into tomorrow. And then later on in the week, more rain into weekend and on into next week. Plenty of precipitation there. And of course, as it's cold, then a lot of that precipitation is, in theory, potentially going to have a risk of sleet and snow. It's never quite as straightforward as that because it does depend on other parameters. It's not down to the upper air temperature and type. It will depend on the dew point and the thicknesses within the atmosphere. All of those kind of things are important when it comes to snow. But the upper air temperatures there would support snow if the dew points and everything else were correct. So it looks cold and unsettled, and there's undoubtedly going to be snow risks at times, I would have thought, from sort of the weekend and then on into next week. Can expect some snow at times. This is a new addition, I think, to West Central in terms of the ensemble. This is showing snow depths. It's like a snow row that tells you how many of these, how many of those precipitation spikes are actually sort of snow. So you see, there is quite a decent chance of snow in Bradford in the next 36 hours. That's primarily from snow showers being brought in on that cold wind that we're going to talk about tomorrow, that cold north, cold wind from the northwest. Then it goes drier. There's very little snow risk as we get through to the middle to the second half of the week. But from the weekend and then on into next week, it does look as though there is a risk of some snow coming through there. Many of those GFS ensemble members look as though they're producing snow. Remember, this is for Bradford, so it's in the north of England. Probably wouldn't be all that representative if we were to look at somewhere like London down in the southeast. But nevertheless, wintry potential, definitely. A lot of those would be marginal, though. You probably would look at that and think, we're going to be buried in snow next week. But it won't be as straightforward as that, because a lot of those snow spikes that you see there are pretty marginal, and some of them would undoubtedly be rain, sleet, wintry mix at times, and that kind of thing. So it's not quite as straightforward as it looks at, but there is definitely wintry potential in the next week to 10 days, particularly I think over weekend and into next week, but also a little bit tomorrow. Temperature anomalies from the 21st to 29th of January, below average of the UK and Ireland, most parts of Europe colder than average as well. Precipitation anomalies close to or a little bit above average. So it's cold and unsettled. That's the theme, cold and unsettled over the next few days. This is how the GFS is looking for Thursday. So this is when we were supposed to be pulling in that easterly wind, but we won't dwell on that too much. Now we're looking at this low pressure around Iceland, and we're starting to re-establish a slightly milder westerly or southwesterly flow around the top of that ridge of high pressure in the Atlantic. We bring wet weather through during Friday and into Saturday. As that clears away, it turns the winds into the north, so we get northerly winds pushing down across the country over weekend. And then there's a secondary area bit of low pressure, but looks quite interesting there on Sunday. We've got the cold northerly wind already established, and the cold northerly winds are following behind it. So as that pushes through next on Sunday, 27th of January, that might bring Brisker some snow, some parts of the country. That gets out of the way by turning it through to a week away, Monday the 28th of January, we're going back into cold, showery northwesterly winds. Moving up towards day 10, we're into a pretty chilly run of northwesterly winds then, and another low pressure sinking through the country, again turning wind back into the north. So you see, it's this idea of regular northerly or northwesterly shots bring cold air out of the North Atlantic, Greenland, and this one is actually bringing proper Arctic air to us, but it would be quite temperate. There's no real northern blocking to support it, but the isobars are actually originating from a very long way north with that northerly, but we've got plunging down across the country at day 10. But you see, very quickly that's cut off as the ridge builds back in from off the Atlantic. So this is the 1st of February, Friday 1st of February, toppling this ridge in across the country. And then we run into a more extended range and we look unsettled again. Low pressure powering through the country. It looks like we would probably, if we could run on beyond that, we can't, but if we could run on beyond Wednesday the 6th of February, we would probably find the wind going back into the north yet again. That was the GFS operational run. This is the GFS parallel run. Again, it looks very similar on Thursday with the wind moving in from off the Atlantic, giving us a milder end to the coming week. But into the weekend, it's already starting to look quite a lot colder. Winds coming in from the north to northwest direction over the weekend with regular wintry showers in the north and in the west too. Moving up towards day 10, low pressure is going on an increasingly southerly track. So the black line here is the jet stream. It's aligned sort of northwest to southeast. It's moving down to the south. That's jet stream pushing towards the Bay of Biscay and northern parts of Spain, with this area of low pressure in the Atlantic digging southwards with the jet stream as well. So cold air is plunging southwards with that low pressure. That's how we are at day 10 on the parallel 6 o'clock GFS run. It's the 31st of January. It looks quite interesting, that chart. Low pressure is somewhere across northern France or the English Channel. Brings the winds in from the east. So cold, wintry, plenty snowy, I would have thought, for some parts of the country as we end January. And we go into a proper northeasterly there on Friday the 1st of February, with that low pressure across northern parts of France then. So that looks really quite cold indeed, with quite a lot of snow being pulled in with those east to northeasterly winds. Then moving up to the end of the parallel GFS run, it's staying quite cold really. Again, no sort of genuine northern blocking, no real block sitting over Greenland or Scandinavia, but there's enough high pressure there to our north and northwest to keep us pretty cold up to the end of the parallel GFS run, which is Wednesday the 6th of February. Winds are still in from the north or northeasterly direction. There will still be more wintry potential as well. The GEM looks like that. So Thursday into Friday, just a little bit colder actually for the end of the week compared to the GFS. Low pressure is more centred to our east. We're pulling down more of a northerly wind at the end of the week. But by Saturday, we're back to what GFS is showing, and we're bringing in this westerly, which is bringing milder air in across the country. But very quickly, we're back into those northerlies again. So we're at a week's time. Monday 28th of January, we find this low pressure is sinking down to our south and southeast. That's turning the winds back into the north once again with the GEM. A more extended range, building high pressure up over Scandinavia. So this one's getting wind into the east. How seriously we take that after this week's failed easterly, I'm not sure. But it does push this low pressure eventually down towards the Mediterranean. And we've got the high pressure at 1,030 millibars over Scandinavia, bringing the wind in from an easterly direction. I'm not sure it's a particularly cold easterly really, so there's no great depth of cold sitting to our east at that point. Of course, if the easterly was to last long enough and was to become long fetch enough, you would start to drag in this really severely cold air that's over Russia. You start to drag that in and push it in that direction, but it takes a little while to start to feed that around the back of the high pressure. And at day 10, although wind is from the east, there is no great depth of cold to be dragged in. Nevertheless, it's still a pretty cold scenario, and the overall trend, as I keep saying, is cold and unsettled, not big freeze cold at this stage. ECMWF, again, for Thursday, still looking quite cold, actually, across eastern parts of the country on Thursday. It's Friday into the weekend, but we bring this milder push of air in from off the Atlantic, but only very temporary. This is only going to last for a few hours during Friday and into Saturday. And by Sunday, wind is already getting back into the north again. So another shot of cold northerly winds pushing down across the country on Sunday. Monday, a week's time, we bring low pressure back in from the Atlantic. It's coming into cold air, has quite cold air behind it, so it's sort of cold zonality type pattern, cold zonal, might lead to some snow. And that would be primarily in the north, but even in the south, you can't certainly can't rule out the chance of some snow, so these low pressures move into the cold air. That's Tuesday the 29th of January, looking very unsettled. Low pressure is to the north of Scotland. Wind again is coming from the north, but it's got a long sea track, so it's been modified quite a lot. But nevertheless, that will still be pretty cold, to be honest. And then this low pressure is sinking down, this trough is sinking down through the country as we get through to the end of January. Again, backing the wind into the east, so cold and unsettled up to day 10, up to month's end with the ECMWF. There's the upper air temperatures. They are a little bit colder at day 10 compared to what the GEM was showing. But again, we're not talking about big freeze type cold conditions. This is how the ECMWF ensembles are looking at day 10 via the postage stamps at the Icelandic Met Office. So we have got on day 10, which of course is the final day of January, we've got 19 members of the ECM ensembles with this area of below average heights over to the south of the UK. A ridge of above average heights is in the Atlantic and trying to get itself up towards Greenland. It's not true northern blocking, it's more of a mid-Atlantic ridge type pattern. The flow and the jet is doing something like that. And of course, this is what both the control and the operational runs are showing at day 10, slinking this trough of low pressure off to our south. We've got another 14 ensemble members that are very similar, but just a little bit further south with that ridge in the Atlantic. So the below average heights are more centred over the top of the UK as opposed to being to our south. Still pretty cold and chilly with winds in from the northwest. We've got another 12 ensemble members again with that mid-Atlantic ridge, but getting a little bit more up towards Greenland, perhaps with the below average heights a little bit more centred to the south. And so these will be pulling in more of an easterly type wind. And then we've got 6, a minority option, but looks like it's building the mid-Atlantic ridge up towards Greenland, but it also has quite a strong Scandinavian high in involved. So it looks like these ones are getting more blocked. The below average heights are further south, and we've got more of an easterly wind. You expect those to be a bit colder, I think, these 6 just here. They'd be colder at day 10 compared to most of the other ECMWF ensembles. In 2 weeks' time, at 360 hours, which takes us to the 5th of February. Quite interesting, actually. It looks like the trend is towards blocking. So we've got 23 ensemble members in 2 weeks' time on the 5th of February that have quite strong northern blocking, actually, from Greenland over towards Scandinavia. The below average heights are to our south. You will think those would be pulling in really quite cold easterly or maybe even northeasterly wind. And it does include the control member of the ECM ensembles as well. We've got another 16 that look like that. Again, they have quite a strong signal for high pressure to be around Greenland. But low pressure is kind of like a bit more centred over to the west of the country. And these would be slightly more sort of southwesterly, I think, with the airflow. So they're a milder option, albeit there is still a northern blocking signal. Just happens to be that the blocking and the low pressure, the trough, are aligned to be bringing wind in from off the Atlantic. And then there's another 12 that, again, has a northern blocking signal. High pressure is up towards Iceland and Greenland. Low pressure is kind of like across central parts of Europe. And so these ones look the coldest. These ones will be bringing in true Arctic air, maybe in Siberian air into the UK on northeasterly winds. But they're a minority option. They're only 12 that are doing that. However, I think we can say that these are a pretty cold option just here, these 23, and put them together with these 12, maybe have a blend of the two. And probably the E72F in 2 weeks is trending towards northern blocking and colder conditions. And even these ones, these 16 just here that are a little bit milder with the position of the trough of low pressure just to the west of Ireland. Even those ones could potentially very easily, just with a little tweak here and there, go into something quite a lot colder. So potentially the E72F is trending towards a colder scenario, I think, particularly as we get through to start of February. Finally, CFS V2 for next month. So these are 500 millibar heights broken down to week periods. The first week period takes us from the 21st to the 27th of January. The coming week has high pressure in the middle of the Atlantic. Low pressure with this trough is up to the north and also over and to the south of the UK. Big trough into the east of America as well. So winter really digging into the east side of the states. And then for us, we're in that kind of position. So again, we're not pulling in true Arctic air, but we are pulling out cold air, pulling in cold air from Greenland and Iceland. So again, unsettled and quite wintry in the week ahead. And then this goes on into week two. It's the 28th of January to the 3rd of February. The ridge in the Atlantic is pulling a little bit further away from us at this point. Trough is deepening over the UK, but we have got quite a strong northern blocking signal starting to appear. So we've got some genuine high pressure turning up over the top of the North Pole. And again, you would expect to be entrenching cold air into that trough of low pressure from that northern blocking. Week three looks like that. Again, a very strong northern blocking signal over top of the pole. It does extend back to a ridge across eastern parts of Europe. So in the east of Europe, you'd be pulling up winds from kind of like a southerly direction in the east of Europe. So a taste of spring, perhaps, parts of Greece, over towards the Black Sea, up towards the Balkans. Those areas might get very mild from this. But for us, we're under, again, this trough of below average heights. And you would expect that to, once again, be pretty cold and pretty wintry. And then we go through to week four, which is the 11th through to the 17th of January. And again, we've got the below average heights over to the south of the UK. Above average heights is a mid-Atlantic ridge extending up towards Greenland and Iceland, doing something a bit like that with the trough and with the jet stream. So again, that still looks pretty cold and wintry even at week four. The temperature anomalies from the 21st to 27th of January are below average, a cold and average week coming up, much colder than average for many central parts of Europe, and really cold over much of the northern, central and eastern parts of America. This goes on into week two as well. This is the 28th of January to the 3rd of February, very cold much of America. UK is a little bit colder than average. Goes a bit milder than average over through some central parts of Europe there at the end of January and start of February. Week three, which is the 4th to the 10th of January, again, colder than average for the UK, beginning to get milder than average for Northern America and starting to get a bit colder again through the central parts of Europe. And then finally, week four looks like that. It's the 11th to the 17th of January. And the temperature anomaly is close to average then. So still this idea that around the middle part of the month, it perhaps starts to get a bit less cold. But up to then, quite a bit of cold weather coming up, albeit not outstandingly so. Precipitation anomaly is close to average. Week 1, 21st, 27th of January. Week 2, precipitation from the 28th of January to 3rd of February. Overall, a little bit on the unsettled side, particularly so for southern parts of the country. Wintry potential, you would have thought, in with that. Week 3, precipitation from the 4th to the 10th of February is close to average. And then week 4, precipitation from the 11th to the 17th of February. Again, it's quite close to average. It's gone really quite dark in here once again, so I better stand up in a moment and turn the lights off. But I'll just finish the video, first of all, and say that it's still the ongoing trend, really. Quite cold, quite unsettled at times, I think, in the next sort of week to 10 days. We're not talking about outstanding depths of cold. We're not talking about a beast from the east or a big freeze-type pattern, but colder than average and unsettled, with a risk of some wind shear potential, a risk of some snow at times. Where and how much, very much to be determined. And it all begins really tomorrow, tonight and tomorrow. So we'll start looking at the snow risk with Snow Watch, and that's going to be today's second video update that will be with you this evening. Right, that's all for now, and thanks for watching.